Well, we've got Scott on the line from Whistler. Hey there, Scott. What's your question tonight? How can we help?
Yeah, my question is, with this weekend being an important holiday, Independence Day, right, you're going to have a lot more people than usual driving around on the roads, mm-hmm, or walking, right, around in neighborhoods and all that, celebrating Independence Day.
Right.
And if you're, like, driving down the road, or you get hit by uninsured motorists as you're walking down the street, how important is it that everybody that owns a vehicle, how important is it for them to make sure that you have uninsured motorist coverage on your insurance policy in case, you know, as you're doing those things I'm talking about, you get hit by, right, uninsured motorists?
Sure.
While you're doing those things I'm talking about.
No, and Scott, thanks for the question. And Danny, I get accused for talking about uninsured motorist coverage too many times, and every week is kind of what I do. But Danny, let you take this and just tell people.
You're going to let someone else talk about uninsured motorist coverage?
Danny's a friend of mine. He slipped me $50 earlier today. But go ahead and, yeah, tell people what uninsured motorist coverage is and why people should have it.
All right. Uninsured motorist coverage is a separate portion of your insurance policy that you purchase, which protects you against being hit either by an insurance or by another driver who has zero insurance, or a driver who has not enough insurance to compensate you for your damages. So it's critically important that you have uninsured motorist coverage, because you may have a $150,000 case or a $100,000 case, but if the person that hits you has zero insurance, or maybe only $25,000 in insurance, then what uninsured motorist coverage does is gives you the ability to turn around and go after your own insurance to make up the difference up to the limits of your policy. I will say one thing too, is that you can, or two things maybe, you can stack those coverages. In other words, you may have two or three cars. You may have $50,000 worth of uninsured motorist on insurance on each car. If you get hit and you have a $200,000 wreck, let's say, then you can stack $350,000 policies to come up with a total of $150,000 worth of coverage. The other thing real quickly is that if you're walking on the 4th of July week and you get hit, I think that uninsured motorist coverage would still apply even if you're not in a vehicle. But Bill, that's your bailiwick more probably than mine, so I'll let you follow up on that.
Right, it follows the person, Bill, right? Not just the car.
That's right.
I know that, right, from, right, listening to you.
Yeah, yeah, and I think it does. It will cover you.
Yeah, and you know what I always tell people is liability coverage, which we're all required to have, but not everybody has it. About 30% of every driver in the state of Alabama, they're not carrying liability coverage like they should. So, but you have to remember, liability coverage is to protect the other person. And it's kind of wherever that car goes, that is covering you. And even if you loan it to your friend, that car is going to be covered, and there's some exceptions, but typically that car, that coverage follows that car. Uninsured motorist coverage follows you. It doesn't matter where you are. You could be like Scott said earlier, walking down the street, walking to your mailbox, riding a bike. It doesn't matter. If you're injured by a vehicle that either A, like Danny just said, either A, has no insurance, or B, not enough coverage, your uninsured motorist coverage, it follows you. It's like a force field. It follows you wherever you are. You could be sitting in your living room, and I actually had this case happen before. You could be sitting on your couch, and mm-hmm, a runaway vehicle come into your home and injure you. You're going to be covered because you have uninsured motorist coverage, and all you have to prove is you were injured by a vehicle that did not either have any insurance at all or not enough insurance.